Round two of the Intercontinental Rally Challenge for 2012, the Rally Islas Canarias. The second of 13 events based in Gran Canaria. It's the first tarmac round of the IRC this year with 15 stages over 241 kilometers. The event centered on Las Palmas de Gran Canaria in the north of the island. With undulating roads and a mixture of narrow and fast sections, car setup and effective pace notes are key. The surface is abrasive, so grip levels are high. Tire wear will be at a premium. Well, the Canaries archipelago is comprised of seven volcanic islands in the North Atlantic, about 150 kilometers west of Morocco, more than 1,000 kilometers south of Spain. Las Palmas de Gran Canaria is the most heavily populated town on the islands. Robert Cazani from Aix-en-Provence in France is a promising 20-year-old making his fifth IRC start. When I was young, he says, I competed in karting, and like lots of go-kart drivers, my dream was to become a Formula One driver. With rallying, though, I can live the dreams that I couldn't when I was karting.
Robert Cazani and Nicolas Klinger. Good luck, guys. Thank you for being with us, all right? Two, one. Fuerte el aplauso para ellos. Sí, señor.
Well, as every rally driver knows, rallying means an early start to the day. A little small this room for me and Nico, the co-driver, so it's a bit of a mess. So today, the rally, two loops of two, no, three special stages. Quite long. So it's going to be quite a long day. Then we head back to service the second time before we go on to a final loop of three stages with a little super special, and that'll be the day. Robert and co-driver Nicolas Klinger getting ready and heading out to the service park. Sleep well, yeah, you? Okay, done with another hour? Yeah, two even. On this rally, you can't cut any corners, so hopefully you wouldn't get any punctures, only if you hit a small wall. That's true, you can't cut anywhere here, maybe two or three times in the whole event. We're starting the Rally Islas Canarias for the first time. Robert Cazani and Nicolas Klinger face a double challenge. Their Renault Megane N4 competes in two categories, production, their main goal, and also in the two-wheel drive class. On the start line, when my co-driver gives me the last five-second countdown, I really try and focus on the first few corners, make sure I start with the right kind of rhythm, and then after the first four or five corners, the racing line and the rhythm seem to flow. The island of Gran Canaria rises out of the Atlantic dramatically at its highest point. It's nearly 2,000 meters above sea level, and it's a great setting for rallying. Almost every stage boasts spectacular views with steep climbs, breathtaking mountain corners, and steep drops down to sea level. Smooth, fast corners challenge the drivers to combine the skills of a circuit racer with the endurance and pace notes of rallying. Seconds are given away, braking too early or too late at every turn. and the smooth tarmac roads use the island's volcanic rock as their base, so they give grip, but they also wear the tyres fast. And the drivers are on parts of the island rarely seen by holidaymakers who fly in to the beaches. Armaghan returns to service, Robert Consani leading the production category. But it's been a tough morning for the French crew. So I think we underestimated the corners a bit on the recce. There's a lot of long corners and we really aren't quite sure about them. Whether we go in early, go in late, accelerate at the beginning or the way out. So that's caused me a few problems on the first loop, but hopefully that'll improve on the second. I haven't driven the Mégane for 5 months as well. I'm not sure if the engine's on full power, to be honest. I can't be sure if it's the engine or if it's just me. But it's important that the driver and co-driver are refueled too. It's a physical sport in a rally car, and they need a lot of calories to maintain their energy levels. That's to stop me falling asleep at the wheel. Not bad. Tastes good. Main goal is to finish, really, so we'll try and keep the same rhythm up in the second loop, make sure we stay on the road as long as we can.
Go. 15 mètres, ciel droit, tapon absolu. Et 10 mètres, gauche à fond, 20 mètres, attention, à droite de plus. Coupe 20 mètres, attention, prêt, épingle gauche, large. 20 mètres, attention, prêt, épingle gauche, large, en sortie.
Stay with us as we follow the young Frenchman and the rest of the crews around Islas Canarias. Welcome back to the Rally Insight on Islas Canarias, round two of the IRC season. And we're catching up with Frenchman Roberto Consani, driving the event for the first time in his two-wheel drive Renault Mégane. But let's take a look at what happened in the rest of the event as well.
Thank you.
The regroup area is a chance for journalists to get and catch up with the competitors. Andreas Mikkelsen from Skoda and Jan Kopecky, his rival, are in a big battle for the lead of the event. Everybody takes notes as the teams do their job. Young German drivers Hemmer Gassner Jr. and Sepp Vegand also under the spotlight. And here is Robert Consani. Bad news for him though, there is a problem with the McGann's engine. He's dropped a second in the production class, but he's only a few tenths off the lead. On the road section, we found that we've got an issue with the throttle. We've got a display on the dash. My co-driver's got all the information and data from the car. And when I'm driving flat out, the throttle really 100% on the floor, it still shows only 81% open throttle. So that explains why we've had a lack of power all morning.
Et le papillon de gaz annoncé 81%. Donc en fait, on est à 100% à la pédale et 81 au niveau du moteur. Donc c'est pour ça qu'on avait des problèmes toute la matinée.
Robert's wife Alexandra is there to offer a bit of moral support.
Ça a pas marché.
Mais quand t'es en montée, tu sens que ça peine grave.
That's only 8/10. You should be able to go better on the next loop. Well, mechanical and personal finishing touches applied before it's time to head to service. A head out from service to the final loop of stages on day one. Let's have a look at one of the stages from on board. Stage 7, long stage with a steep climb, some very fast sections, and a tricky downhill to round it off. Well, we'll isolate a section of the stage and ride on board to see how these Skoda rivals do it. First, it's Andreas Mikkelsen. A bit of a moment in the stage for Andreas Mikkelsen. Let's ride now, same section of the road. This is rival Jan Kopecky.
A levá 6 minus před horizont, dlouhá, dlouhá, brzda utáhne 6, do pravé 6 plus předem. A 50, levá 2 a pravá 5 plus, váže horizont vlevo, do pravé 5 předem, 40, brzda levá 1 před horizont, 30, pravá 20 a hned levá 10. 20, levá 6 předem, 80, horizont pravo, do levé 4 a pravá
Well, Capecchi wins that particular piece of the stage by just a second, but he remains in second place behind Andreas Mikkelsen. Well, back with our Frenchman, Robert Consani, in his Renault Mégane. So the end of the first leg, Consani and co-driver Klinger arrive back at service. They've taken the production lead by more than a minute, but their engine problem still isn't fixed. Well, we thought that we'd solved the problem, but turns out that's not the case. We've still got a lack of power going uphill. It's a bit disappointing though, really. It's kind of hampering us and means that we can't go any quicker. But even faced with adversity, crew still got a smile on their faces. Car's dirty, so I'm giving it a little wash. We're a little team, we haven't got too many mechanics. So stay with us as we head towards the finish in the Canaries. Little homework for our featured driver, Robert Consani, and Nico Klinger, his co-driver, watching the video of the recce to check their pace notes for the second leg. Yeah, last night I was so tired that we only watched two special stages through. So this morning we've watched the third one, and now we're ready for breakfast. It's going to be a long day today, quite a tricky route as well. So we've got to be careful, make no mistakes, make it to the finish. I really want to make it to the end of this one and celebrate with the team. Well, for driver and co-driver, a chance for a little bit of family time. Breakfast with his wife and daughter. Calm before the storm. And then back out on the fast flowing tarmac for the young Frenchman. Well, back at the front of the field, the battle still rages between Andreas Mikkelsen and Jan Kopecky. It's very close as well. Using the simulcam system, we'll see exactly what the difference is between the two Skodas, as if they were both on the stage at the same time. After losing the overall lead on stage 10, Kopecky wants to increase his pace on stage 11. First on the road, he drives flat out and gradually creeps away from Mikkelsen. But now second on the road, Mikkelsen can manage his pace, knowing Kopecky's split times. And as he sees that Kopecky is faster, the Norwegian picks up the pace. Running consistently in third place overall this weekend, local hero Luis Monzon. And again, comparing here, stage between Monzon and fellow Spaniard and fellow Peugeot driver, Jonathan Perez. The lines and commitments say it all. By the end of the stage, Monzon 22 seconds quicker. That's a second per kilometre he's gaining over his rival. And he's rewarded for his dedication. Every IRC event sees the Colin McRae Flat Out Trophy presented to the driver who most embodies the spirit of the late World Rally Champion. And it's Luis Monzon who receives the accolade on Rally Islas Canarias. So we rejoin Robert Consani hard at work in his Renault Mégane, closing in towards the end of the last stage.
Sur gauche à fond long, 10 mètres. Gauche 4 points panneau, sur droite 3 points. il reste deux bornes maintenant, droite 3 moins. 10 mètres, attention frein, droite 2. Attention frein, droite 2. Sur, long gauche 4. Long gauche 4. Sur droite 4 moins bref. Droite 4 moins bref. Gauche à fond absolu, sur gauche à fond absolu et 20 mètres. Gauche 4 moins reste intérieur. Sur droite 3 plus long. Sur droite 3 plus long, reste intérieur, fais gaffe. Tiens 3 moins. Tiens 3 moins. Sur gauche frein, droite 2. Droite 2. Et entre lui et puis les chiens, on freine beaucoup plus. 10 mètres, droite 3 moins, reste intérieur. Sur gauche 3 moins. On n'a pas de frein moteur, sur droite 3 moins, mignon.
C'est bon.
C'est bon. C'est bon.
Ouais.
On the road section between the penultimate and the last special stage, we realized that we were losing oil out of the gearbox, so got to say we're pretty nervous. Finally, we managed to get to the finish, and then we drove on the autoroute 30 kilometers an hour just to make sure we got here. So only 500 meters to get into Parc Fermé. I really hope the gearbox doesn't pack up now. Finally, joy as all the hard work pays off. Kansani wins the production cup class here in Gran Canaria. And in their second category, two-wheel drive, they were fifth place. Not bad, considering the engine problems they faced all rally. Well, after the retirement of Ricardo Mura with turbo failure, Kansani's only rival for the Production Cup win is Romanian Italian veteran Marco Tempestini. In his Subaru Impreza R4, navigated by Doran Pulpea, he manages to hang on to his junior French rival, but a brake problem on day one means he stays over a minute and a half behind the class leader, and he's unable to make up the ground in the second loop of stages. Nevertheless, runner-up on the event gets him 18 points. Joan Vigneres in the Suzuki Swift 1600, proving the quickest of the two Spanish Suzuki Swift drivers. He won more than half the stages in the two-wheel cup field to take the win in two-wheel drive, first in class and sixth overall. Gorka Agostegui chasing him all the way. Identical cars, swapping stage times throughout. But despite taking 10 seconds off the leader on the final test, runner-up by 18.6 seconds. And Hiel Marrero in his Honda Civic Type R kept the pressure on the dominant Suzukis, in the end rewarded with third place in the two-wheel drive cup to complete the podium. And he was eighth overall on the rally leaderboard. Germán Hernández in the Civic Type R also posting a good result. Unable to keep up with Marrero or the two battling Suzukis. Nevertheless, he finished in fourth spot in the two-wheel drive cup. And he was 6 minutes 13 behind the overall winner of the two-wheel drive category. Still made it into 11th place overall. Well, taking advantage of an engine misfire for leader Andreas Mikkelsen just before the last special stage, Jan Kopecky claimed IRC victory number 6, his first in 2012. He's a happy man. And Mikkelsen, heartbreak for him. Victory in the palm of his hand, taken away by mechanical problems.
To my first win, so. But okay, on tarmac.
So confirmation then, Jan Kopecky ending up with the win for Skoda ahead of rival Andreas Mikkelsen in another of the Czech-built cars. Luis Monzon for Peugeot claiming third place overall. Well, there seemed to be little doubt that Škoda would take the win at the end of it, and it was Jan Kopecky who took the champagne and his first win of the season. He goes straight in second, but he's 18 points behind overall leader Andreas Mikkelsen. So that's it then, round two of the 2012 IRC is done and dusted. Next time out, more asphalt action, the Circuit of Ireland. See you there in April.